Hallelujah, that's good, Pastor Ahan. Amen. This mighty man of God that has availed himself a usable vessel to deliver this powerful, searing, and sobering message. Oh, my goodness. We're going to meditate on this as we sing the song "Let the Church Say Amen," because we are going to agree on it. We are going to meditate on it. Amen. We're going to embrace it. And then we're going to nail it to our hearts. And at the closing of this song, our covering Pastor Seaman will bring remarks. Let the church say amen as we meditate on the word received. Amen. Hallelujah.
Everybody
say amen. God has spoken.
So let the church,
say amen.
Yeah. Can I get a witness?
Let the church, say amen.
To what his plans are.
Let the church,
to what his word
say
says.
God has spoken.
Let the church
say amen.
Amen. Ooh, yeah. Make this your response
amen.
To whatever he said.
Amen.
From the healing of your body
amen.
To the raising of the dead.
Amen.
No matter how you're feeling
amen.
Or how your world. Really
amen.
Battle on through the night
amen.
Cause you're gonna win the fight
amen.
Even in the valley
amen.
Or standing at your Red Sea
amen.
Continue to say
amen.
Cause your help is on the way
amen.
My God has spoken. I heard him. So let the church say church
say
God has spoken.
God has spoken.
Hallelujah.
Let the church
say.
Amen. Indeed, God has spoken, and we are saved. Amen to God's word. Greetings to you, Beacons for Christ Ministry. God bless you on this first Sunday of the year 2024. Amen. To you, Pastor Randy, God bless you as you continue to be a real kingdom soldier, a real soldier of the cross. You can't say that today. Today we have soldiers of the culture, and we have soldiers of the congregation. I'm so glad that you are a soldier of the cross. So, Beacons for Christ, God bless you indeed today to the RITs, to the DIT, to the members, just doing a fabulous ministry service. God bless you. To my dear friend, Reverend Eunice, hey, all right. The sermon, folks, to the thinkers, they are saying, what? In the world, how could a man preach this and a woman is his covering? So let's talk about it. Let's help people out. We must always read God's word in context. And you know what? Are you reading the signs? Deborah, you know why Deborah was a sign? She was a sign in her day that the men were not in their place. And God used her. Now, here's the thing that's, and I'm going to help us all out here. We don't read that Deborah was married. We don't know. But I tell you what, if Deborah was married, God would not have used her unless she could keep her marriage in check and honor the man that God had placed in her life. Let's understand that. There is no way I can usurp a man's authority in this house or really anywhere. Yet as we look at the world, as we look at Bermuda, for example, can we count on in government that males are leading us in the way God would have us to go? No, we can't. And you know how I know that? Because we can't even count on it in some churches. We're not supposed to be pastors. So the key is that, and you said so much, I could talk about this all day, but I'm not. Women, you know, I'm going to talk, you're going to be like, is pastor seeming a woman? Let me tell you something. Women are too emotional. Women supposed to be bedding up, they're leading God's people as a pastor or as a minister, and they're more concerned about how they look, that they got the right, latest clothes on, that they can capture your attention, that they got the latest 5-foot weave, and so that they can show what caught. That's what God is speaking about. And Eve cannot pastor. And Eve cannot pastor because Eve is going to get caught up. But look at that fruit. But forget what God said. That fruit looks mighty good. You see? That's why I will say continuously, man have got to man up. Stop letting Pastor Seaman out-Bible you. Stop allowing Pastor Seaman to be a voice that you refuse to be. Now, let me say this. That's why God said, listen, in the last days, I'm going to pour out my spirit upon all flesh. If not, ain't nobody going to make it into the kingdom. So I'm going to pour it out on the male, the female, the servant, the one in, you see? So there's that balance, yet it never erases. Look at this screen here. Well, actually, this screen, well, no, still. Look at the screen, more women. Let me check. Yep, more women. Why? Because the man have become a part of the falling away. And so let me say this, you know, judgment over him. Judgment is happening right now. If you think that we are not being judged, you're out of your mind. The reason that we're fighting to get males in the church is because judgment has taken place. When men step out of order, and they don't step up to the plate, cover the women. I wouldn't have minded being an evangelist. Let me evangelize and write books. As a matter of fact, I always like sharing truth, meaning sharing something that actually happened. When I had my last pastor, Pastor William A. Lee Jr., God had told me I was going to pastor one day. But I liked his preaching so much, I actually told God I had the nerve to tell God. I said, God, I'm good now. I'm good. This man can preach. I'll be a second. I'll preach here and there, and I'll write books, and I'll do my stuff. Well, can you imagine if I saddled with that thought? He ain't in Bermuda. He went on to greener pastures. Right. And so God clearly trusting me. I know where I've been called to. So I want you to be secure, Shekinah Worship Center. You to be secure, Beacons for Christ Ministry, and all others that God has called. And you know how you know? Is that preacher preaching the word? Or is she so feminine and so emotional that she wants to itch the ears? You want a Q-tip? What you want today? I am not going to breastfeed people. I'm going to preach God's word. All right, so let's get through that. Just in case anybody got those thoughts. Clear it up, all right? The signs are, as a matter of fact, you better name one of the three people that are hot in the news right now. That's the mess going on. Man, big, strong, big old man, playing the fool. Let the church be the church. But when you mix it, you're going to be in trouble. And so, the issue is, and that was so powerful, the Isaiah readings. When women are so sensual, they will lose their sensitivity for God. And this is what's being spoken against. And so that's why my call is, whoever you are, women, man, you better hold the line. You better put the shields up. You better fight the good fight of faith. We're not around here being no fluff. This is serious. I can't read my writing on that one, Doc. I'm going to have to go back to it later. Yeah, wild grapes. We got a bunch of wild grapes. You know, I went to the grocery store the other day, and it's not the first time, but I always look at the green grapes, the purple grapes, and then how you get a grape, you say it's got a cotton candy flavor. I'm just trying to wreck that. I'm trying to wreck it. I see it. That's got to be some type of wild grape. I never heard of that. But it's in Don Lindus. I see it all the time. And I'm tempted to get it. If I say, I rebuke you, you're not real. Anyway, we cannot sissify the gospel, right? Now, what's happening is no king. So if you have no king who honors God, the unrighteousness cannot exalt that nation. When churches become seeker sensitive, you know what that is? I wrote it down here. You're merchandising the pulpit. You're pimping the pulpit. When you don't preach, just preach God's word. Don't preach to people. People, we change left, right, center. No. Go to the word that doesn't change. You don't do that, you're a pulpit pimp. That's who you are. That's right. And you know what you're producing? Wild grapes. That's what you do. And you know what it said? It said it's no rain. And I said, no rain. You know what that means? No water from God, no anointing on that. God ain't anointing stuff that's not his word. It took us to point two. Man, I tell you, I'm betwixt and between, Pastor Randy. The fullness of the Gentile. The next person that gets saved might be the fullness. Now, on one hand, I'm like, yes, Lord, let the cup be full and take us out of here. On the other hand, I'm like, I've got a bunch of heathen relatives. Don't know God from their own name. So if somebody gets saved and they're the fullness of the Gentile and that number's it, they're lost. And trust you and me, if you can't serve God in Bermuda, as blessed as we are right now, I know how. You ain't going to be able to get saved during the rapture. I'm just telling you, after the rapture. Forget it. Then I thought about this. I said, you know what? I can remember, and some of you may have the similar, some experience. I can remember I was getting married, right, 1985. And this is actually true. This is true. I was getting married, and one of my bridesmaids was not there. I won't go into the drama. My girl, she wasn't there. I was like, no, we're going to wait. We're going to keep on waiting. Let's wait a bit longer. Well, she finally came. I won't tell you. Anyway, she finally came. I was like, good. Now we can go to the wedding. Hello? Did somebody just get it? That's the fullness of the Gentile. When that final person makes it, we're going, folks, we're going up. We are going to be caught up to meet him. And that's our comfort. Don't you look at churches, oh, they can do anything. You can't do nothing. It's image. Yeah, you better rejoice. I got you by the Holy Spirit. I got you dressing in white. We come into the wedding and talk about you wearing jeans and cut off. You know, I got you dressing in white. No, come as you are. Come as you are. Let me read what I wrote with that one there. I wrote a big note. That's all you needed. My big note. No. Because come as you are means come worldly. Come the way I feel. I talked about this morning. No. Don't do that. The world becomes more attractive when the godly people are not being constantly drawn to God. We exhibit a false gospel. And I will say again, to round this off, as a female, who is a pastor, it's my function and role. I know, and I say it continuously, The moment I step out of the pastor office, I'm a woman. And listen, women are the ones who mold the world with the children, you know. So the reason that we have a lot of people that think that they can go to heaven from back bedside Baptist, and listen, let me say this, let me be bold. You can go to heaven, but if you think that your children are going to go to heaven via your bed, you are lying. Oh, we just learned to walk close to God, seeing you at the bedside and never. Now, I'm not talking about churches that cannot meet. We're clear on that, but I know I'm talking to a whole lot of people here. You can go down the street. I've got 300 churches you can choose from. But you're going to tell your children they never had to gather. You're going to get licks. And you're going to see your children off to hell. You see? And so the signs are all there. I thought it was a beautiful graphic, even the imagery, Reverend Eunice, showing the signs literally that are happening at a rate that we've never heard of it. Why? Technology, AI, all the wonderful things I can do with AI. You know what I keep thinking? No wonder they're going to be fooled, because this stuff is real. I'm saying this and I'm reeling. The other day I did a Happy New Year's greeting for Pastor Peter in Kenya. So I said, let me take off my glasses. So I took off my glasses. I recorded it. Of course, I can't see him recording. So then I got the recording and I sent it to him. I said, Maria, girl, if you buy that other program, you can take away all the dark colors all under your eyes, because I work so much. I said, girl, I said, and I'm going to do it, you know. I'm already scheduled myself to do it. I just have it's the upgrade units from what we're using. I'm going to buy the paper. I just said, listen. I said, girl, they'll never see. Now, I even never got time to do it, but I'm telling you, they can do it. AI can do all this stuff. What am I saying? The world looks more attractive. So if the church you all in here, if you don't show them how attractive the church is, they won't believe it. So when they experience, they say, oh, so-and-so don't go no more. That's the great falling away. And they say, oh, see, we don't need church. Yes, you do. But you're going to be accountable for the souls under your remit, your children, your grandchildren. Whoever's under your remit, you don't see them in heaven, blame yourself. Did you witness? That's all I'm talking about, if you witness. Now, once they become adults, they're responsible for their children. I know I raised mine. They would, but they wouldn't say they weren't raised right. You know they were raised right. So, signs upon us. What do we do with them? Don't become as the world. Remain the church. Let the church be the church. Blessings abound. God bless you.
Amen. Hallelujah. Let us put our hands together. Hallelujah. For our covering pastor, for her commentary. Praise the Lord. God bless you, woman of God. We so love and appreciate you. We so love and appreciate you, Pastor Randy, for the word of God. And what I'm going to do, hallelujah, put our hands together again for our Pastor Randy. And most of all, for the word of God. Hallelujah. Glory, for it is life. Glory be to God. It is marrow in our bones and our bodies. It's the blood that keeps us flowing and keeps us going in Jesus' name. Let us say a covering prayer for our pastors in Jesus' name. Heavenly Father, we rejoice. We are so grateful unto you, for you have given us pastors after your own heart, Lord God. We thank you, God, for our covering pastor. We thank you for Pastor Randy, who has a passion, Lord God, to deliver your word, to feed your people, Lord God, to lead people to you, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, for how you are using them. We thank you, Lord God, for the revelation that you give to them, Lord, through your word. And I'm praying in Jesus' name, a special prayer of blood covering over them, Lord, a hedge of protection upon them and their families, Lord, in the name of Jesus. And I'm praying, God, for kingdom citizens, Lord God, that you would give them kingdom citizens, Lord God, to continue to hold their hands up, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Kingdom citizens, Lord God, who's going to reflect, Lord God, what they are doing as they are preaching the word. Allow us as your people to walk your word out in Jesus' name. We thank you, God, for the souls as a result of your word being delivered, souls being won to the kingdom, people being encouraged, Lord God, and pushed to go closer to you, Lord. May you continue, Lord, to be with our leaders. Keep them covered under your blood. Meet their every need, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God, in Jesus' name, even for their desires, Lord, that you have given them, Lord. Thank you, God, for giving them patience to continue to wait on what you have given them. In Jesus' name, we pray, Lord. We love them and we thank you for them. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Glory be to God.
Heavenly Father, thank you, thank you, thank you for such a beautiful and powerful message today. Each and every song, the word that's been read, every moment of this service was clearly, Father, your amazing and beautiful covering. Father, you have made a way. There's no mistake that none of us was here today to hear such a word. And all those who will hear this message, it's a reason behind. Let's take the stand with it and make all the moves that are required, because you're going to speak to us in such a special way, because this word is a powerful message. And we thank you, Father. We thank each and every member who showed up today, each and every one that's going to be listening. Father, in the name of Jesus, we are so grateful. We're so excited. The atmosphere in here today was amazing. And that is because you were in the house. And I thank you for it, Father. Again, I thank you for pouring into our pastor in such an empowering way. That not just that he brings the word in such an amazing way, but Father, he does it in such a humble and strengthening, encouraging way. This is kingdom business. And these type of examples are so essential, especially, Father, in such a time as what we are living in. And we know the attacks in the church are at extremely high. Pastor spoke over today, and we're just so excited, Father, because we're getting fed. And we thank you for the covering message from our covering pastor, who continues to show that excellent leadership and guidance. And I thank you, Father, because it pours into us and we can take it out there. And we can go out there and make a difference and help others, being that mighty vessel that you would have us all to be. Again, we thank you, Father. And may we all leave here and take these goodies and pour it in and send it out in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. And thank you, Brother Roger, for the covering closing prayer. Thank you, Pastor Seaman, for the additional nuggets and the beautiful additional comments. We love you and we thank you for your presence with us. And thank you, Reverend Eunice, for the powerful covering prayer of both of them. It's been absolutely a blessing to have served with each of you today. It is beautiful when we come together in this anointed Zoom room to lift up and magnify the name of Jesus together and give him all of our time and all of our attention to him in Jesus' name. God bless each of you. We're going to move into our beacons affirmation at this time, and may we each speak it boldly from where we are. Hallelujah. We are beacons for Christ. Off the beams of our Father we shine, battling against the spirits of darkness, we hold the line. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, we align, Anchored in his strength, we hold the line. Our branches will bear kingdom fruit. We are attached to the holy vine. We remain resolute in kingdom purpose. We hold the line. We take on the great commission to spread the gospel to all mankind, steadfast, unshaken, and kingdom assigned. We are beacons for Christ, and we hold the line. Hallelujah. Praise God. Oh, glory be to our God, the Father, God, the Son, the all-omnipotent, omniscient, great Alpha and Omega, whom we love and adore. God bless you. Thank you so much for taking the time to join us today. We ask that even as you go throughout the week, that you allow for the word. The word says, he that has ears to hear, let him hear. Oh my God, we serve a God that always gives us free will, even as he presents and gives. He still gives us that free will to take up that cross. Hallelujah. So this word, this searing message received today, it's supposed to transform us. We are required to be transformed day by day. And I pray that this message lands on good ground in Jesus' name. God bless you as you go throughout the week. Remember that we are beacons for Christ. Amen. Let our light so shine before man that they may see our works. But glorify God the Father in Jesus' name. God bless you. Blessings abound.